Today, let us discuss another concept in module 4, which is numerical solution of ordinary differential equations. So in the previous sessions, we had seen two methods to solve ordinary differential equation. One among that was Taylor series, and the another one among that was modified Euler's method. So today let us discuss about the Runge-Kutta method. So here in this session, let us discuss about another method, which is called as Runge-Kutta method. So this method is also called as Runge-Kutta method of fourth order. Why do we call it as fourth order? Because we are going to use the four constants, four parameters we are going to evaluate here. That is the reason we call it as Runge-Kutta method of fourth order. So before getting into the method completely, let us see what type of problems can be solved by using this method and other things. So as it is, like as we have discussed in the previous two methods, it is only the initial value problems we are going to solve here. What are the initial value problems? An equation which has been given with the initial condition, which is called as an initial value problems. So the standard form of an initial value problem is dy by dx is equal to f of x comma y, and it is equal to y of x naught is equal to y naught as the initial condition given. So for this type of problems, we are going to use Runge-Kutta method. And how it is used? So let us see. The formula for Runge-Kutta method is this. To find the value of y at x naught plus h by using the formula. So what is that formula? Is y of x naught plus h is equal to y naught plus 1 by 6 into k1 plus 2 k2 plus 2 k3 plus k4. So what are this k1, k2, k3, k4 are? So k1 is h into f of x naught y naught, and k2 is h into f of x naught plus h by 2 comma y naught plus k1 by 2, and k3 is h into f of x naught plus h by 2 comma y naught plus k2 by 2, and k4 here is h into f of x naught plus h comma y naught plus k3, and here h is the step length. So this is a formula, and you have to write the formula completely while answering any of the problems, while it's solving any of the problems in the examination or in the notebook. So it is always better to write the formula repeatedly. And for this formula itself, you will have a specified marks allotted. So it is must for you to write the formula. So try to understand what you need to do, in how many stages you need to do, what is the step length has been given for us, and all those things. Only then proceed to solve the problem. So look at the, let us understand in a better way by using one, by solving one of the problem. So consider an example one. Employ the Runge-Kutta method of fourth order to solve the initial value problem dy by dx plus x plus y square comma, and it is the initial condition given here is y of 0 is equal to 1 at x is equal to 0.2 by taking h is equal to 0.1. So you are already familiar with using these values and the step length in the previous two methods. So the same condition applies here also. So the given problem here is dy by dx is equal to x plus y square, and the condition is y of x naught is equal to y naught. The value of x naught is 0 and the value of y naught is 1. And it has asked us to find the value of y at x is equal to 0.2, and by taking the step length h is equal to 0.1. So h is equal to 0.1, start from 0, go up to 0.2 in steps of 0.1. So that is what is the problem given here. Yeah, so here let us try to solve the problem. We need to compute. What we need to compute? We need to compute y of 0.1 first, because it is asked us to take h is equal to 0.1 and use the value to compute y of 0.2. So consider it as a stage 1. X is equal to 0.1 is the stage 1, and x is equal to 0.2 will be our stage 2. So the by the data given, so I told you x naught is 0 and y naught is 1. And f of x comma here is x plus y square. H is equal to 0.1. So k1, what is the formula? Try to recall your formula which we have discussed in the earlier slides. K1 is h into f of x naught comma y naught. So h is 0.1. What is our f of x comma y? Our f of x comma y is x plus y square. Replace x by x naught and y by y naught. So you get it as x naught, x naught plus y naught square. Substitute the values for x naught and y naught, and it gives the value as 0.1. Similarly, write down the formula for k2. K2 is h into f of x naught plus h by 2 comma y naught plus k1 by 2. So h into f of x naught plus h by 2. X naught is 0, h is 0.1 divided by 2. So that this entire thing you're going to replace in the place of x in your formula. So this x has to be replaced by x naught plus h by 2 with the suitable values. Plus y should be replaced by this entire thing, y naught plus k1 by 2. So this is your function. X should be replaced by the first term and y should be replaced by this term. And substitute the values for h, k1 and evaluate it. We get the answer as 0.11525. So this is your value of k2. K3, so evaluate k3 by using this formula. As I said, your x0 in the f of x comma y should be replaced by this. And y in f of x comma y should be replaced by this. And h into f of x, this one. So this is what the values we get in place of x and y. On simplifying, we get 0.11685, which is the value of k3. So similarly, evaluate k4. K4 here is equal to h into f of x0, x0 plus h into y0 plus k3. So h into, this is the values, and substitute the suitable values here, and we get the value of k4 as 0.13473. And final function for us is y of x0 plus h, which is equal to y0 plus 1 by 6 into k1 plus 2k2 plus 2k3 plus k4. So substituting the values for x, y and k1, k2, k3, k4, on simplifying, we get y0, y at 0.1 is 1.1165. So we have completed one stage of calculation at x is equal to 0.1. Similarly, we have to evaluate the second stage at x is equal to 0.2 now. So when we are evaluating the second stage, the first stage values act as an initial value for the second stage. So our x naught is no more 0 as in the previous case, it is going to be 0.1. And y naught is the final value of first stage, which is 1.1165. So f of x comma y remains the same, only the values of x and y are going to be changed. And h is 0.1, which is given for us. So write down the k1 formula, which is h into f of x naught y naught. Substitute the values and simplify, you get 0.1347. And k2 is h into f of x naught plus h by 2, y naught plus k1 by 2. So as done in the stage 1, the same way, x should be replaced by this and y should be replaced by this. And these values will give us h into f of this entire thing. So this value of x0 plus h by 2 is 0.15, y0 plus k1 by 2 is 1.1839. So simplifying, we get 0.1552 and k3, k4 also you need to evaluate in the same way. So write down the final formula, introduce the substitute the values of x, y0, k1, k2, k3, k4 and simplifying, we get y of 0.2 is 1.2736. So this is how you have to evaluate. So we have done the problem in two stages because the values of x and h given for us in the problem was like that. So instead of h is equal to 0.1, if it is given as 0.2, the entire problem could be completed in one stage itself. So first you need to observe all those things before start doing the problem. So let us see another example. So this is example 2. It has been given as 1. Make a change. It is example 2. Use Runge-Kutta method of for fourth order to solve this problem. Y of 0 is 0 at x is equal to 0.1, taking h is equal to 0.1. So in the reading the problem itself, you must understand how many stages that you have to do it here. So your x0 value is 0 and you have to evaluate x at y at x is equal to 0.1 and h here is 0.1. So only one stage will be there. So write down your values of x0, y0, f of x comma y, h and k1 is this, k2 is, this is how you need to understand, you need to evaluate. And k4 also you have to evaluate by using the suitable formula and substitute the values of k1, k2, k3, k4, x0, y0 and all those things and you get the arrive at the answer of this. So this is our second problem is all about. And example 3, using Runge-Kutta method of fourth order, find y of 0.2 for the equation thus, y of 0 is 1 and take the step length as equal to 0.1. So now understand how many stages that you need to do. X0 is 0 here, h is 0.1. So once you give x, h is equal to 0.1, that is the step length 0, 0.1 and 0.2. So you have to do the problem in two stages. So look at the first stage, x0 is 0, y0 is 0, f of x comma y given in the problem is y minus x by y plus x, h is 0.1. So k1 is h into f of x naught y naught. So replace x by x naught, y by y naught in this formula. So you get your f of x naught y naught. Multiply by that h, you get the value of k1, which is 0.1. Similarly, k2, h into f of x naught plus h by 2, y naught plus k1 by 2. And the values of these will be 0.05, 1.05. So substitute those values here in this formula. So you get it as 0.091. So similarly, k3, if you do the same evaluation with the suitable values, you arrive at 0.091, and k4 is 0.0832. And substitute all those values of y1, k1, k2, k3, k4, x0 and y0. We get the answer y of 0.1 as 1.0912. This is our stage 1. So we have to evaluate stage 2. As I said earlier, the initial values of stage 2 will be from stage 1. So your x0 value is 0.1 and y0 value is this. Function remains the same. H is 0.1. So k1, write the formula, make a substitution and evaluate it. K2, write down the formula, make a substitution, evaluate it. K3, k4. Similarly, you have to evaluate it and substitute all those values in the final formula. And this is the answer is going to be 1.1679. The one thing that you need to remember, the values of stage 1 and stage 2 will not be of much difference. They'll be varying only in the decimal places. So take care of these things before you proceed to the next problem in the examination or in the anywhere, like however it is. So whatever, wherever it is. So you need to observe the values what you have got it. So after that only you have to conclude it. So this is how you need to do the problems at Runge-Kutta method, and this is a very easier one. And you need to remember the formula very carefully and evaluate in the evaluation procedure while calculating in the calculator also you must be careful. So with this we will conclude it. Thank you.